now you don't get to turn around and face the middle. The good news is that nobody has to stomp or clap or participate. Just look at this. I'm going to say why I was called here. The name, the title of this speech is called Different, She Said. Different, She Said. Does anybody know where that comes from? Any idea where that quote comes from? Okay. Do you wear it? Please tell me. You raise your hand? Oh, you're going to? Okay. So let's look at it. Does anybody know the play Chorus Line? Fairly musical Chorus Line. Okay, I feel so old now. Oh my God. No, no, Chorus Line. It's a good thing I set this up because I have the music here. And we'll see where this is from. I want to talk about being different because I've been different all my life. Basically, you are going to embark on a career, on a lifestyle of being different. And it isn't always going to be easy. We worth it. But it isn't always going to be easy. So, let me come over here and play this. The inspiration for this morning's speech, the inspiration for the talk, is about a mid-hit song. But let's play through Chorus Line. Just to let you know, Chorus Line is a Broadway musical from 1975. I talk about being different. You know, musicals, when you think of Broadway musical, you think of huge scenes, huge stage and scenery, and people in amazing costumes. A Chorus Line, you know what the set was for a Chorus Line? What the set was is this. It literally was this. It was a line. It was a line on the stage. Dancers stood on that line and talked to a voice, an offstage voice. It didn't sound like much, but it became, it started in 1975, it became the number one show on Broadway. In fact, it was only surpassed recently as the most popular show ever in the history of Broadway in terms of performances. So of course, like, this was a very pivotal moment with all the artists, all the performers. And I want to play you a song, a little piece of the song that I'm about. Here we go. It's going to be loud as hell, ladies and gentlemen. We're providing the testament to my music. So here we go. This is the words. So basically what's happening in that song is this woman is accepting the fact that she is going to be different. Not beautiful, but different. And that is really basically what I'm going to talk to you about, is accepting the fact, if you are really wanting to go to being a performer, an artist, that you guys are going to be different. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with being different at all. Because artists see things differently. Performers react to things differently. Artists have a different type of brain. I always say this. My kids both are artists in a different way. One's a computer artist, the other is a furniture designer. And they see things different from everybody else. An artist and performer sees things as completely different from everybody else. Let me give you an example I'm talking about. So this morning I was drinking water, and I come to this conundrum in the water. And this is a classic conundrum about being different. What do you see here? Is this glass, is this bottle, let's say, you've heard the classic half empty, half full conundrum? Is this bottle half empty or half full? How many of you, by show of hands, please, think this bottle is half empty? Go ahead. Thank you. About 12% of pessimists, okay? Joking. How many of you, show of hands, think the bottle is half full? All right, optimists. Well, here's the difference. I'll tell you the difference between a performer's mindset being different or a regular person's mindset. Regular people look at this and say half empty, half full, yes or no, one or the other. A little bit of an extended different thinker says, you know what, guess what? It's both half empty and half full at the same time, right? If you look at it as half empty and half full at the same time, then you're getting somewhere. But real performers, real artists, real people who really think different, you know what they say? Half empty, half full, who cares? What is it? Is it really water? Maybe it's vodka, maybe it's not vodka, it's not vodka. Maybe it's turpentine, maybe it's explosives, run out, he's a terrorist. It could be that. There are many people are thinking, who designed the water? Who's the water? Is it Quebec companies or international? And all those type of questions, that's the type of questions that artists and performers do. And that's what being different really is all about. You guys, I'm going to check my notes here to make sure we don't follow them. You know, when I was just for laughs, people always ask me the same question over and over again. Why are comedians so crazy? Why are people in Hollywood so crazy? Why are they so insane? I don't know if they use that word, it just makes my mental illness, but that's what they ask me. Why are these people so crazy? Why? Because they're not normal. What do normal people do? I don't know if you've taken statistics classes or math classes, but what do normal people do? If you want to go to Hollywood, become a performer, if you want to go become a musician, you want to become an artist, what do your parents tell you? It's impossible, right? They say the odds are so against it. So normal people look at that and say, you know what, you're so right. Because it's impossible to do this. It's impossible to go ahead and make it, because the odds are so stacked against it. So what do normal people become? They become accountants and lawyers and dentists and doctors. Teachers, I'm sorry, but they become panting normal gigs. So who goes ahead and takes on the challenge of doing something impossible? The abnormal folk, the different folk. And the different, when I say the different folk, I include in it, and obviously this is where I include you, this is where you're going with this. But there's nothing wrong with being different. There's nothing wrong with being different. What's wrong is the way people treat different people. And that is changing, because you know what? Society needs different people. Society needs the artists. Sometimes society looks down on performers, but society needs performers. Why? Why does society need performers? Why do they need artists? Because it's the release valve. I call artists and performers the tiger bomb of society. You know what that means? It's the people who perform, the people who go ahead and do stuff you saw on stage, do things you're going to see throughout the day. They're the ones calm society down. They're the ones with things that are too tense, too crazy, and too uptight. The world needs it. It's a release valve for tension. And people, you know, businessmen, politicians, they need performance. That's why you see time and time again what happens when countries get together and they have these huge meetings. They talk about the future, and they talk about armament, they talk about economics, they talk about their social policies. What do they do usually at the end of the day? They go to a performance, they go to a ballet, they go to a concert, they go to a show. Why? Because it allows people to relax and feel human again. So that's really what being different is all about. These people need you. Now, all right, thank you.